Gracias, señora. Arriba, Peru.
More rock star than chef. Going to a market in Lima with Gaston and Curio is a highly interactive experience.
Our world is a world of spicy, colorful, a little bit of citric, lime, Peruvian lime, which is great for anything. Red onions are very important in our food too. What we do is we use our biodiversity.
Curio and his wife operate restaurants in 20 cities around the world, including New York and Sao Paulo. He experiments with traditional Peruvian cuisine, including, that's right, guinea pig dishes. With his own TV show, he has become a figurehead for a country that's growing fast.
Finally, we're starting to build this post-post middle class that we need to have, that any country needs to have. And we want to bring a lot of people to Peru, using food as a power of seducing people all over the world.
Arriving at his seafood restaurant, it seemed the seduction was going well.
We came from Ecuador yesterday. The trip is mainly to eat.
This restaurant specializes in ceviche, a dish of spicy raw fish marinated in citrus.
Diablo Rojo, Mr. Gabriel Campoverde.
Acurio buys his product directly from fishing communities.
All right, here we go.
Clean, fresh.
We ended the day at his flagship Lima restaurant, recently voted the 14th best in the world by Diners Club Academy. It tries to tell stories through food, this dish depicting wild nature. It's all a long way from some of Peru's poorest indigenous communities. But Acurio says the growth of the country's cuisine can have a far-reaching impact.
In agriculture, finding how can we join in a strong relation of friendship between the fields and the city. In education, building schools for people that don't have the opportunities. We need to build our whole chain if we want to Peruvian food getting all over the world.
High ambition indeed, but it seems he has a few supporters. Nick Parker, CNN. Lima.